decoupling in audio or other circuits. Decoupling is a very, very important issue. When you want to make an audio amplifier or high frequency circuits, and here I've drawn a three-stage amplifier. The first stage, a preamp, second stage, also a preamp, and the third stage, an end amplifier. Of course, we know that an end amplifier takes a substantial current. That means that the current to the amplifier must not be limited too much. And the basic circuit from the decoupling unit is this: a resistor, a capacitor, and then we send the current to the preamp or the end amplifier. So here we have the signal line. Here we send in, for instance, an audio signal between 0 hertz and say 18 kilohertz. It's amplified here and here and here, and finally we hear the sound out of the loudspeaker box that's here. But the big problem from such a circuit is that we have here a power supply lead, and in some cases the audio signal can travel on the power supply lead to the other stage, and that can give a lot of problems. So that's why we need decoupling from an audio amplifier circuit. And this is a standard way to make a decoupling unit: a resistor here and here a capacitor to ground. Wanna demonstrate it now. Here we have the resistor from the preamplifier, and here we connect a capacitor from say 100 microfarad to ground. The positive here and the negative here, and here we do exactly the same thing. In the second amplifier stage, capacitor to ground. And here also we do the same thing here. Capacitor to ground. And now it's almost impossible that signals travel on the power supply lead to other stages from your amplifier and disturb the proper functioning from the other circuit. I have to tell, of course, that this is the positive lead, must be connected here. Also the positive lead from the preamplifier here must be connected, and here that's already clear. Here we need a quite low value resistor, say between approximately 1 ohm and 10 ohms, and the capacitor that you need to decouple an end amplifier in the 10 watt audio range can be between 470 microfarad and 4700 microfarad. And that are good values for an end amplifier. But for these preamplifiers, they take a very, very tiny current, say 3 milliampere or so, and the resistor then can be between 100 ohms and 470 ohms, and the cap can be between 100 microfarad and 470 microfarad. So here we see the audio signal traveling through all the three stages, a powerfully amplified here in the end amp, but all these three amplifier stages are decoupled. That means that they don't influence each other. And when you want to do it very, very perfect, this is the best circuit to make. Again, the R, that means the resistance, the resistor, the electrolytic cap, bridge the electrolytic cap with a 1 mega ohm resistor and then a 100 nanofarad capacitor, so 0.1 microfarad. All the influences on the power supply line will be damped very, very severely, and that means that all your amplifier stages get a pure, a clean voltage to work on. So decoupling is very, very important. In old tube books, you often see this kind of circuit. On the left side, a coil. It's a choke coil, and that choke coil also acts as a decoupling unit, because the resistance for high frequencies is high, but the resistance for the voltage that the tube needs is not very high. So the tube gets its proper voltage on the anode, but it cannot send from the anode amplified signals into other parts of the tube circuit. So also a way to decouple a tube circuit. You can also do that with a resistor, no problem. It has more or less the same effect, but on the other hand, a resistor is not frequency dependent, and a coil is. Anyway, this is a good circuit to decouple, the ideal circuit. Decouple all your amplifier units well, and you will have the best results. Here you see, for instance, a small amplifier that I've made, approximately 2 watts. Here you see a preamp, another preamp, and when you want to integrate this preamp or that preamp into a power supply unit, here at first a resistor, then a capacitor to ground, and then supply that unit. Here exactly the same, and here you can see that I've already done that with that red resistor. I've made a decoupling unit, and I've made that decoupling unit with the help of a transistor. That's also a very, very good way to decouple an audio circuit. I want to draw that now. Here, I hope it's clear, my camera zooms in and out, sorry. Here, for instance, a resistor, or not a resistor, doesn't matter much. Here the positive lead, here the transistor, could be a BD139, and here the negative lead, negative, and here a Zener diode from say 12 volt. Here 18 volts, here the emitter, here a cap, output cap, here a resistor, say between 100k and 1 mega ohm. Here are the outputs. And here we have the positive output, here the negative. And here we add small voltage to the Zener diode. And you have to use the BD139 up to say 600 milliampere output. And here a cap. This is a decoupling unit, also a stabilizing unit. And here the positive from the cap, here the negative, and here a resistor from 1K5. When there's hum here, or whatever disturbing signals on the power supply lead, you don't find them here. All the disturbances on the power supply lead are completely suppressed here. So here you have a completely hum-free output voltage. And the reason is that the amplification factor plays an important role, and you may multiply the value from this cap here by the amplification factor from this transistor. So when the cap is 100 microfarad and the amplification factor is 70, we have 70 times 100 UF cap. That is seen by the electronic circuit connected here. So this circuit connected to this decoupling unit sees an endless capacitor and is completely free of hum. Important in this case, use the BD139. It has a good amplification factor. Don't go higher than 18 volts. So, also this is a way to decouple an audio unit with an extreme hum suppression. But the more simple units are drawn here with the help of a resistor and the cap.